Hello, how is everybody doing? Are you enjoying the Vlogmas series? Can you leave a comment literally right now over here down below in the comment section and tell me if you're really, truly, genuinely enjoying the Vlogmas series? Because I am. And if I get really good feedback and stuff from you guys, I'll upload even more frequently here on YouTube. In today's video, as the title may have already told you, we are going to be trying out a viral TikTok makeup beauty hacks. I'm really kicked about these because I feel like there's a lot of videos out there that do stuff like this, and I want to try some of these for myself and see if it's actually worth the hype or not. So let's not make this intro long at all. For a change, I will not ramble, and let's just dive right into it. Okay, so we're gonna start off with our very first makeup hack. Now, if you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I really do enjoy makeup hacks. Rather, let me rephrase. I really enjoy making my makeup routine simpler, my beauty routine simpler in whatever form. So if there's a way I can use one product in multiple ways, I am here for it. However, in my opinion, so far, a lot of these TikTok-y hacks look really, really gimmicky to me. So I'm really glad that we're going to be doing this together today. The first one I have over here, let me go ahead and play it for you. We're going to watch it together and then we're going to figure if we do it.
Foundation powder mix.
Okay, so I don't know if I did that right, but this is what I ended up with. Moment of truth. So I already feel the foundation much thicker, so that's a plus. Oh my god, bitch, look at that. Let's see if it covers this big ol' sits. What the f- This is some little video shit, guys. Look at this. Try it. Try it.
And we are going to try it. So, she was using Maybelline's Fit Me. We are also going to use Fit Me. You guys know I love this Fit Me powder. With the foundation, I was a little bit confused between what to do because I didn't want to use a completely full coverage foundation because otherwise what would the loose powder do? So I went ahead and selected Fit Me because I realized these two might go well together. So I'm kind of giving it a little bit of a benefit of doubt in advance, plus the fact that this one is buildable. So this will build onto this. Am I making sense when I think like that? Am I a weirdo? I don't know. Let's see what comes of this. I have a feeling I'm gonna regret this. Wait, I need to get a separate tray because for a second there, I was just gonna pour the foundation into this, but then I don't wanna land up ruining my product. मैंने काफी ज़्यादा लिया है, या काफी कम लिया है? I don't know. इतना सा तो ले लिया है. It's not a thick layer. There's just a little bit of it in my opinion. I'm just gonna keep this here in case it falls. Gosh, I feel like I'm doing like a science experiment more than a TikTok beauty makeup hack. Okay, that's a lot. Is that not a lot? I feel like that's enough. Typically, okay, that's, are we doing half a face or should we just do full face? I feel like let's just dive in full face and this is making me very uncomfortable for some reason. Okay, so we are going to take this Mishran. It's obviously made it a little bit thick, so now I can show you properly. This is what it's looking like. It's not a lot of product, keep in mind, it's just flat. So it may look like a lot of product, but I don't tend to use a lot of foundation anyway. So I hope the makeup gods will be with me today. Okay, I feel like I took a lot of product. Like a lot of product in the sense, I don't even usually need this much product. I wanna take a second here and say, this has gone on so beautifully. The Fit Me is really great to work with, the powder as well as the foundation. But right now I'm really impressed because the foundation is not this easy to go on usually. In a sense, it's easy, but itna coverage nahi milta hai. And in a very strange way, I don't know if that makes sense because the product is a mattifying product. The foundation is a mattifying foundation for normal to oily skin. It's called the matte poreless foundation at the end of the day. Maybe let's let it dry because right now when I'm looking at it, can you see this little glow I have here? Okay, let's just do up the full face and let it set and see what the finish feels like. Never loved the instant coverage of this foundation this much. Very impressed. Very, very impressed. The brush I'm using is the Jovita Pack brush, by the way, which is also really nice and super lightweight. Very, very great to work with. I've been reaching for this quite a bit. I really like this. This is a hack that I'm definitely gonna say has passed. I really like this. I don't even need to go ahead and add setting powder on my face because it's dried down to a matte effect. And it's not feeling. What I was expecting from this was that it would feel a little bit dry on my skin because, hey, I'm a dry skin girl. I was expecting it to feel a little bit heavy because this is quite a nice bhari bharkam loose powder over here. I thought that it would feel a little bit cakey on my skin. I didn't think it would look cakey, but I thought it might feel cakey a little bit on my skin. But oh my god. Nope. I'm looking at it on camera and it's looking nice, but I'm looking at it in the mirror and it is looking even better. I always feel like my makeup looks better in person. That's just a me thing. I like this. Am I gonna reach to doing this on a regular basis? I just might. We're not doing a full face of makeup in this video, so I'm not gonna go ahead and do every single step. Let me quickly jump off cam, do my brows, concealer, the few things that we're not doing the hacks with, and come back to you in a quick second. Okay, I am back. The camera is focusing. I've gone ahead and done my blush, bronzer, brows. I am not having the best brow day. So let me just go ahead and address that. Actually, shave karte karte mere se thoda sa zyada ho gaya woh din, but it's okay. Maine usko thoda sa overdraw kar diya hai to try and compensate for it. I have the next few hacks ready to go, but what lipstick shall we apply today? Okay. I am going to wear 26th Jan from Aerified on my lips really quickly because I feel like with makeup and even like in general, lipstick is that one thing that I never ever ever miss out on. I also casually want to slip in over here that we have 12 days of Christmas going on Aerified, so make sure you guys catch these offers while you can. I will leave details for the offer down below in the info box or as a pinned comment, so make sure you check it out because I'm really like keen on doing fun offers for you as and when I think we can. As a small business, we can't this very often, but we're gonna keep trying. Also, just in case you want to know about any of the other makeup items I'm wearing on my face today, don't worry, that will be linked down below as well. Full face of makeup details will be mentioned there. Also, how cute is this little crystal glass that I have over here? I think I received this in PR and I received flowers in this or something. I try and repurpose whatever I can that I receive in PR around my house. If you guys have seen my living room makeover, sofa makeover video, which was the first in my Vlogmas series, you'll know that I also used that beautiful tray as my centerpiece on the center table. If you haven't watched that video, catch it please. Okay, so as it turns out, I had 5 viral makeup hacks shortlisted for this video. And the next couple of them are around the eyes. So let me show you what the next one is before we go ahead and attempt it. Okay, so basically the idea is that you heat up your eyelash curler, like the rubberized part of it, the rubber part of it over here. And when you heat it up, it's sort of like you're ironing your lashes. I wasn't all that surprised when I saw these simply because I follow Lauren Giraldo's vlogs quite a bit. And she does this all the time, but she does it with a lighter. Now, with a lighter, I'm like the worst with trying to figure lighters. You guys have seen that even for my scented candles around the house, I use that electric lighter. I'll insert a picture over here. I find that much simpler to use. I can't just do lighters at all. And that will not work on this. So we're going to take the blow dryer route. I hope this is going to come till here and not fall and make a mess. Let's go ahead and... Bas ho gaya, kaafi garam tha wo. This is the Cisco blow dryer in case anybody cares. Again, we'll link it down below. My hand is feeling the heat. Oh my god, I just realized something. Wait, isn't the eyelash curler supposed to have rubber on up as well as down? Hello, focus me, aa jao. Isn't there supposed to be rubber up as well as down both places? Was I just about to burn my eyelashes? Wait, I need to look this up online. Okay, I'm good. Some have up and down and some have only down. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and give this a go and pray to the gods that my lashes don't burn. even though this lash curler smells like it has totally burned. वो जलने की पता है बाल जलने की ऐसे वाली पास आ रही है. Releasing, putting, releasing, putting, releasing, putting pressure. Yeah, I don't think it's showing on camera at all. But it is. Like, I can see the difference between the two lashes over here, for sure. Utna nahi hua hai, but hua hai. Because main dar dar ke kar rahi hu. Let me go back in. Everything is hot, guys. So if you do try this at home, or rather don't try it at home, I don't know, your call. Your own responsibility, please. Just be very careful. Oh yeah. I don't think it's showing up on camera. Is it? Let me try and zoom in. Can you see the difference between the two? It's halka sa hai, ye thoda lifted lag raha hai, and this is looking straight out plain. Let me look over here. Bang on to you for a second. Can you tell the difference? I'm gonna leave you zoomed in for a little bit. Even though it may be a little bit of a weird camera angle, I'll just leave you a little bit zoomed. I just don't know if I like it enough. Let me put it like that. Let me go ahead and reheat it. Here I thought this was gonna be the easiest of all the hacks, huh, by the way. My stupid brain. Okay. I like it, but I don't like it enough to do this on a regular basis. Like, I would use a curler, sure. I'm not opposed to curlers, even though I don't really use curlers regularly as well. But this is too much. The time you spend on this or the effort you spend on this is not worth it for the final result. It's very okay and so-so. I'm gonna give this one a pass. Rather, let me put it like this, I'm gonna give this one a fail. That's what I meant. Okay, we're going to stay zoomed in for a little bit because the next one is also something that I'm personally really excited to see if it works. Again, I have mixed feelings about a lot of these hacks in general. Let's take a look at it first. I was gonna just start. Let me show you the video before we really get into it. Okay, so I'm gonna have to put different music there because copyright strike, but I'm a little confused. Did she take the loose powder, apply it on the lash, and then go into the mascara and apply it? Or did she go ahead and just do both together? Because wouldn't that ruin the mascara a little bit? Because essentially you're taking mascara, putting loose powder inside the tube of the mascara. I don't know if that's such a great idea, in all honesty. I'm taking some of the K by Katrina loose powder for this. Inka packaging mujhe kabhi nahi jamta. Ye netting na. I know it makes sense and I know it works for a lot of people and I know that it's also very practical if you're traveling and stuff like that. There's something about it that I have never truly fully understood. If you guys have an explanation about it, please tell me, because I would like to know. Like, I would like to learn if there's something over there that I don't know. Okay, so I have a completely separate eyebrow brush over here. There's an angled brush on the other side and a spoolie on this side. I don't want to completely destroy my mascara, so I am absolutely not going to go ahead and use that spoolie over there. Taking that K by Katrina loose powder, this feels so weird. Taking that powder, really trying to coat it, huh? That's why it's taking me a beat. Guys, this one's gonna be a fail, I can feel it. It's gonna be so weird if this is actually like something that works. And I'm gonna put this inside my mascara, which I'm really not. Okay, so we've gone ahead and done like sort of like a double dip with the powder and then with the mascara. I'm really trying. Like, I'm going from root to up, I'm moving it around. Nope. Hard pass. Hard fail. Just nothing. Absolutely nothing at all. Do you see it? It's barely doing what the mascara does by itself, let alone give me any added volume and added dimension and added length or whatever the hell it's supposed to give me. Nope. Nada. Zilch. Kuch nahi. Empty. I'm going to let this eye just remain aise hi, and we're going to move on to the next hack. Okay, so while I have one more eye related hack, I don't feel like I want to do that because I really want to move on to a hack that I think might actually stand a chance. So for hack number 4, we're going to do this viral nose contour hack. I am going to leave credits for all of the videos that I'm showing you guys down below in the info box. So make sure you guys check that out if you want to know more about the creator I'm referencing for these hacks. Now, let's go and give this a shot because I have a feeling it might actually work. Here's hoping. I'm going to use this color bar contour for this, which I quite like. So let me quickly give you a before shot of my nose because I think this will be handy. Okay, I'm looking for like the thinnest brush I have. So the thinnest brush I have is EY number 222 from PAC, which is an eyebrow brush of theirs. I'm going to go ahead and try this with this, and I'm going to try to do it in silence so I can concentrate and also so I can make a reel out of this, if I'm being honest. Holding it down in place and really focusing on not moving this because the last thing I want is a tedha contour. The idea is to give yourself a nose contour by hiding the middle portion and just contouring the sides. Now in some videos people have gone separately on either end. In some videos you take a bigger brush and just go over and, you know, kind of just do both sides. I have a fairly small nose usually. Usually? Does my nose change size? I have a fairly small nose in general, so I'm just going to take a small brush and go on either side. We're going to do this, you guys. Really rooting for the theory that this one works. I'm scared. It looks like I have muck on my face, like on my nose. Taking a clean brush to really go ahead and blend. I have no idea how this is gonna look when I move the brush, but I may already be unhappy with it because of just... I have a line in the middle of my nose. This is rubbish and it looks so bad. This one's gonna be a fail, you guys. If you don't know how to contour your nose, just practice or just skip the contouring. Who the hell cares? Instead of going ahead and creating a geometric line. I've really blended this out like for a solid 5-7 minutes and it's not budging. It is not budging. Maybe I'll try it again, use a bigger brush and just do that middle application next time. But no, this is not working. This one is a hard fail, and I thought this would be the one that actually worked. My god. FYI, I didn't even set my under eyes today, which I typically can never skip. Even if I'm just having a concealer day and a no foundation day, I can never skip setting my under eyes because I get lines super easily. I've been filming for a little while now and I have barely any lines coming together compared to normally jo ho sakta tha agar main loose powder lagana bhool gayi or something, and I think that's because there is loose powder in the base routine today. So far we're 3 fails and 1 pass. I think I have just about salvaged it, but I can still see some weird patchiness over here. Okay, so essentially she went ahead and drew the line for the winged liner but didn't complete it, and instead completed it with the false lash and then just filled it in. That should work, right? That should work. I've not done it like that before, but I have gone ahead and given myself like a lift with the help of lashes. But let's try. After the way this worked out, I don't want to play the guessing game. I have these Haya lashes from Hina Henna, which I actually really like. I like enough that I have gone ahead and actually cut them in half. You know, if I really like a lash, I go ahead and cut it in half because I really like the outer lift. So I'm gonna go ahead and... Oh wait! Sabse pehle wing banana hai. Sorry. Almost forgot that part. We're gonna do everything on this eye, huh? Instead of just doing both, because it's probably gonna be a fail anyway. My roller lash is literally breathing its last. I think it's time to totally put it away and get another one. I'm using the Iconic one, which is a really, really great liquid liner, by the way. And even though, like, I know a lot of people don't love liquid liners because it's relatively tougher to use than like a felt or pencil or whatever, it's a really easy to use one. Highly recommending this if you are in the market for a liquid liner. Does that ever happen to you while getting ready? You forget where you left the bottle, or you just have the dhakkan in your hand and you don't know where the bottle is, stuff like that. Meri haya ko thoda sa glue karte hain. Sorry, I'm all about the dad joke in life. If you've made it so far into the video, leave a comment and say that in the comment. Meri haya ko thoda sa glue karte hain. I know a lot of people need like tweezers and stuff, but to be honest, I don't. I love lashes. I can just go ahead and use my nails and do it. Or even before, I used to have long nails. I could just use my fingers. I'm in the market for really good magnetic lashes. The ones I've tried are all really shit. If you have recommendations on good magnetic lashes, hopefully that are also available in India, please leave me a comment and tell me. I think I made a mistake. I shouldn't have taken this half one. It's looking really weird. It's looking like my lashes. That's fine. Wait, I need to look at this TikTok again and figure how she's done it. Hold on, hold on. We need to get this one, guys. We need to get this one. And it's time for the giveaway in this Vlogmas video. Go ahead and read all of the instructions mentioned on the screen really carefully and follow them to the T to be able to win this giveaway. All the best. So basically her wing is really short. Even hers is a half liner, I just realized. So that's not the problem. We will still use Haya. I've used this on Instagram and I don't think I've showed this on YouTube. I'm just going back in, making a fresh wing, a much... Yaar, chote wings mere se hote hi nahi hai, I think. Anyway, let's just give this a shot. Now this is exactly what my worry was, right? Typically when you do your wing, it's where the curve in your eye is, your socket. Ye jo andar ka khadda part aata hai, your wing typically goes at the start of that of the side. The lash can't sit there because it's a curve, which is why our lashes by default when you stick them have to end before the curve starts. So just in case you're somebody who wears false lashes and you're wondering why do my false lashes taper off, come off from the outer corner, it's because of that. If you have a curve, it can't hold on to it for that long or properly. I really want to figure this out, one second. So it's definitely not gonna like stick there, but like stay there for a long period of time. Just gonna take a felt at the moment. Friends, can you see the way this is like, can you see this? One second. This. It's hanging. Literally. I'm quite annoyed. I mean, I thought that at least this one would work. I mean, the one that I thought would not work has worked. And the ones that I thought would work have not worked. I'm gonna rule this down as a fail because the curve is just, it's, I don't know, guys. Should I try them again? I feel like a hack, the idea of a hack should be that it gets done easily. Not that you have to use strategy to even use a hack. Because then how the heck are you a hack? Go ahead and apply your liner and just stick on a lash like you normally would. That's simpler. Okay, and with that, we come to the end of today's video. It's been hits and, well, actually it's been hit and misses. Literally 1:4. Very, very still comfortable on my skin with that first one. By the way, this is something I'm actually going to recommend you try because it actually did simplify two of my steps into one. So this seems very worth the effort. I like the finish as well. It's gone matte to how it typically is, but it's feeling very, very, very comfortable on the skin. And it definitely did add on to the coverage. Sorry, I'm looking there a little bit because I'm like, is my skin actually looking like that with using two really full coverage, heavy, meant for oily skin kind of products? Because typically these two products are meant for oily skin. I happen to love them because I've learned how to use them and I moisturize like a crazy person. I did, by the way, prep and prime my skin before starting this video for sure. Today's Wear Fam comment shout out goes to Priya Vimal. Thank you so much for always talking to me in the comments. You guys know I love reading, liking, hearting and responding to each and every one of you. There is a giveaway somewhere in this video, so make sure you guys participate in that as well. I'm really sounding like a Rajdhani, so I should just go slow right now and tell you that I love you. I'm grateful for your love, for your support, for your views, for your comments and likes that hopefully you are leaving on this video, and turning those bell notifications on so you get alerts, because apart from my daily uploads and Vlogmas, I mean in general I upload a lot of content over here on YouTube as well as on my Instagram, so go follow me there. But I'm actually working on some really cool, I don't want to say anything, there's some really fun stuff coming up that I'm really excited for, that I've actually planned with the intention of like, hey, fun content. So stick around to this channel because I have a feeling you're going to love it even more with each day. Mwah! I love you guys. Thank you for hanging out with me. I will see you tomorrow.